Welcome back. Now, record numbers of dogs and other animals bought as Christmas gifts are being abandoned in Ireland following the holiday season. Animal welfare groups say an exceedingly large number of animals are being handed in at this time of year, in spite of their campaigning work. Here are just some of them. Take a look at this.
When your day is long and the night is yours alone, and you're sure you've had enough of this life, hang on.
Now, here with me in studio to discuss the problem are members of PAWS, People's Animal Welfare Society, Gina Hetherington and Sarah Connolly. You're both very welcome. Gina, first of all, tell us about PAWS.
Well, PAWS is an animal rescue that was set up by my mother and I. There was no organised animal rescue in North Kildare area in 1997, so we decided to have a go. And we were going to do it in a very small way, and basically it just snowballed. And now we're dealing with all over the country. We're dealing with Kerry, Cork, Galway. We've even had dogs from Belfast.
Yeah. Why does this happen every year? Like, it's so well known, a pet is not just for Christmas, it's for life, but yet it happens every year. Why does it keep happening?
Well, I think basically what happens is that mommy doesn't want a dog. Inevitably is what happens is mommy doesn't want a dog and the kids want a dog. And they talk daddy round.
Right.
And daddy says, well, it's Christmas, we get them a puppy. And 6th of January arrives, kids are going back to school, daddy's gone back to work, mommy's left with a dog that she didn't want in the first place. And it's pooping all over the house and chewing the furniture, and it either ends up locked out in the back garden and becomes unsociable, or it ends up in a dog pound or a rescue centre.
And is this the problem, that people just don't foresee, like, after the kids have gone back to school, or the problems that dogs have? They need to be trained, they
exactly.
need to, they're only little pups, they are going to run around. Is this, they just don't foresee that?
Yeah, but little puppies grow into big dogs. This
well,
is another
yeah.
thing. I mean, that dote that you
little
have in your hand
here,
there,
look at this.
That was found up in Tala since Christmas, and our vet figures that it's going to be a border collie type dog when it grows up, which means it's going to be a decent sized dog.
Yeah.
And people see this little ball of fluff and they think, oh yes, we'll have one of those. And then it starts to grow, and or it either knocks over the kids because the dogs grow bigger quicker than the kids do, or it's the house training. People don't have the patience to actually house train the dogs.
Should people, should people be held more responsible for pets when they buy pets?
Absolutely. Our belief, and many of the dog trainers and vets agree with us, is that there's no such thing as a bad dog, it's a bad owner.
Yeah. So when you get dogs like this, then you were obviously trying to rehouse them. How do you decide what's a good home for a dog?
We have conditions of adoption. There must be somebody at home during the day, or else we insist that they take two dogs, it works out very well, because otherwise you end up with a bored dog in a garden all day doing damage and barking.
Yeah.
We also ask that there be a fully fenced-in garden, that you not be garden proud, yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Diggings and shrubs go and the works. And we also ask that there's no children under 7, preferably in the family, because again, children under 7 don't really know how to treat a puppy properly, and the puppy grows and the child doesn't. The puppy grows faster than the child, I should say, and the child gets knocked over.
But would children not give a lot of love and attention to small dogs?
They would, but a lot of people, I mean, I had a lady call to me in the last few days who wanted a companion dog for her dog. And I asked her, because she'd got the small children, and I said, how do the children get on with the dog? And she said, oh, it's great, the dog lets the children ride around on his back.
Right.
Now, that immediately, the minute I heard that, I sort of said no. You know, we've got to the stage where we know by talking to people, we know in the first 15 minutes if they're good at home or not.
Sarah, what's your involvement with PAWS? What do you do?
I'm a kennel worker.
So you work in the kennels with the dogs all the time. So yeah. do you see them in a bad state sometimes, like in a really bad state?
Yeah.
When a dog has been abandoned like that, do they need extra care then in their new home? Do they need to be looked after better, or do they sort of, like...
A rescue dog knows they've been rescued.
Oh, right.
There's no doubt about it. The more that we see, the more that, the more we believe that. I mean, this little one here, Jerry Halliwell, we called her.
Jerry Halliwell.
I mean, as you can see by the damage to her chin, she's been through a lot. I'd say she was probably attacked by some other dogs. All she wants to do is sit on your knee all the time.
Yeah.
Because somebody's actually being nice to her, so she wants to cling to them, you know.
This little girl here is... What happens if you can't find a home for them?
We keep them.
Do you keep them?
We have two dogs that we've had since we opened 3 years ago.
Yeah.
We have 40 in our care at the moment. And I have 13 of my own, at 12, and Jerry. Hopefully I'll get a home for Jerry. If I find that people won't take a dog for some reason,
Are any of them put down?
I keep them. No, the only reason we put down a dog is if it bites somebody.
All right.
Aggression is the only reason, because we have a non-kill policy otherwise.
And how can we prevent this from happening again next year?
Neutering is the big thing.
You're saying neutering, a lot of crossbreeding and stuff.
We've got 11 puppies in since Christmas, and this is, the 10th of January?
Yeah.
And there was some of them in pairs found in the car park in the square, that kind of thing. Mm. People's dogs have puppies, they try to get homes for them, they can't, so they just dump them.
Neutering is really important. Tell me the story about Sparky there, isn't it?
Sparky here was found the day before yesterday. My dad came in with his dog and he said there's a little dog tied to the gate.
And I just want to read this. This was tied to Sparky. Sarah's holding Sparky there. Please, dear PAWS, please can you look after my dog, because my mammy won't let me keep him in the house anymore because my sister is having a baby and they said it has to be put out now. I will give you £10 to look after it. It is so lovely. He sleeps in my bed with me and on my lap and in the house. He's trained also. He's very quiet and he is good, and his name is Sparky. I love him very much, so will you be good to him and please look after him? Thank you. I will send you money from my allowance every week. Please love him. He loves to say hello by licking your face. Thank you so much. I washed him yesterday, so he's nice and clean too. Thank you so much. I'm sorry, but I'm only 13 and a half, and I can't look after him. So, that's a really horrible...
That happens a lot. Quite frequently, we get boxes of puppies left outside the gate, and people don't understand that we run this from home.
Okay.
And every dog that comes into our shelter, every puppy is vaccinated and wormed straight away.
Right.
And every adult dog is vaccinated and neutered.
And
so
hopefully...
the huge costs of running that are people don't even think about.
So if you have a home for any of these dogs, let us know here, or let PAWS know, and we'll give you the number after the break. After the break, we have complete news and sport on the way.